Why these niggas got gold ceilings and shit? Why God need gold ceilings to talk to me? Why do God need colored windows to talk to me? Why God can't come where I'm at, where he sent me? If God wanted to talk to me in a pretty spot like that, why the hell he sent me here then? You know what I mean? That make ghetto kids not believe in God. Why?
Often I ignore what's in store when within war and wind up selling, asking me what I'm in for. And this morning I ask myself, what will I live for? Is it money, hungry, never satisfied, dying to get more? That depends on if I'm the sole provider one depends on. If that's the case, fourth and goal, the option is the end zone. On the other hand, this can't be what I live for, because if I'm locked for less, how could I ever promise my kids more? To be a good father, daddy can't be no crook. And any mortal words of bun, shorty can't eat no books. Dilemma, stress, and the etc.'s got me drinking more. The only thing that seems to calm the tremors, and I'm thinking more. I'm reaching for an older reference called the Hustler's Code of Ethics. Good and evil's known as relative to whoever holds the leverage. As a child, I wanted a father look up to and hold in reverence. I live to be the one in life that he bestowed a blessing. So I mean much more to my child than only presence, because I'd curse the gift any day just to know his presence. So I'm willing to die to not be living a lie and justify that, which I'm not willing to try. Will you live for what you die for? Or will you die for what you live for? You willing to die for what you live for? And will you live for what you willing to die for? I live for free speech and the protection of my voice, the focus on less submission, neglecting I have a choice, the higher responsibility that comes with that free fight. We live to speak death while others that die to speak life. We'll scrap to the ends of the earth to defend what I verse, despite what's intended at first. A semblance of the thirst for the apprehensive, left uncomprehended, it becomes a vicious example that's said at its worst. Until I gave explanations of how things after hours occurred, I seen effects and didn't realize the power of words. I mean, one of the fellas hit me, filling the stories that you tell, it hit me, the victory over the odds and the felon in me. Still I flip the coin, the lit I kick, left kids destroyed, handing applications to OGs with hopes to get employed. Cause I swear I die to speak the truth, but I lie to live, trapped between the gift and the curse that I have to give. Haven't figured out how to twist the tube and angry sense, till Ali told me that we true and false strangely mix. And now I aim to speak with the love of an angel's lips, remain angleless and strangle out the cantankerous visions, a gangster in prison. Still the statements I'm giving traditionally conflict with the faith of the willing, but does it if shorty is the truth and a lie? Cause I gave him proof to decide, discern, learn on his own, and bear the fruits of his mind. Thus chooses to abide by, like I try to define lies when things are relative to the mind's eye. So if I die accidentally when I skydive, my quest for what's right lies in the truth that I died trying. If I was to pass away into the night sky and sacrifice committing evil with a righteous deed, will I be justified?
What price are you talking about, sir?
The price of freedom is death.